Hello learners, I welcome you all in yet another video lesson of DLET program of NIOS course code 504 unit 1, How Children Learn Mathematics, and the topic for today's lesson is Development of Mathematical Concepts, Mathematics Learning During Early Childhood, Ways of Learning Mathematics. Before moving on the main topic, let me share with you the proposed flow of the lesson. In the beginning of the lesson, I would share with you the lesson guide along with the expectations in terms of learning objectives. Then we will discuss about the concepts as such, and then we are going to discuss about the categories of mathematical concept along with development of different concept categories. Then we will discuss about learning of mathematics during early years and also the ways of learning mathematics. At the end of the lesson, we will recapitulate and there is a take home task for you. Coming on the lesson guide, during my presentation, I will explain the different concepts. You need to attend to my voice and the slides as well. You will find important words, sentences have been highlighted for your attention. I have also put summary at the end for your attention. There are some questions and exercises in between and at the end of my presentation. You should attempt these questions and exercises after going through this video lesson. Here are the learning objectives. After attending this video lesson, you would be able to understand the development of mathematical concepts during early childhood. You will get acquainted with the different ways of learning mathematics during early childhood. You will be also able to draw implication of the theory of cognitive development for children of different subjects, mainly mathematics. Now, there is a question for you. I would rather ask to you, are the concepts in general and mathematical concepts in particular are same as body of skills and collection of facts? Further extending this question, can by showing a picture of bird, we make a child learn what is bird as concept category? I think not, because I am missing out many dimensions causing a partial understanding of what actually a bird is as a concept category. For example, a bird is a furry flying creature with feather. It is not a mammal, and there are different types and appearances of bird as shown in the visual. Bird also lays eggs. Therefore, if I am not discussing all these dimensions and characteristics, I think I am not justifying with the explanation of the concept. Therefore, the concept can be defined as an idea of something which is formed by mentally combining all its characteristics and particulars. That is, a concept is a category or a construct which defines something holistically by identifying and explaining all its characteristics. It can be understood as construct giving complete understanding of the phenomena. There are two types of concept. One is primary concept, which we acquire or which are derived from direct sensorial experiences. The second type of concept is of secondary concepts, which are derived from other experiences beyond sensorial or direct sensorial experiences. There are also different categories of mathematical concept. When we come on mathematical concept, we distinguish or categorize different mathematical concepts into four categories. The first category is pre-number concept. The second category is number and operation on numbers. The third category is measurement concept. And the fourth category is special thinking concept. Now we will deal with each of the categories separately, one by one. Here is a representation on the slide that how mathematical concepts gets developed. When we talk about pre-numbers, after pre-number concept, we attain number concept. After attaining number concept, we attain measurement concept, and after attaining measurement concepts or gaining or learning measurement concept, we gain or learn spatial thinking. When we talk about pre-number concepts, pre-number concepts include four kind of concepts. The first concept is matching within the pre-number concept. The second one is sorting. The third one is comparing. And the fourth one is ordering. When we talk about number concepts and operation on numbers, we are concerned about counting, use of numerals, and operation on numbers. When we talk about the third concept, that is the measurement concept, we are concerned about measurement of length, breadth, volume, and area. When we talk about spatial thinking, we talk about shapes, figures, and dimension. How a child thinks about shapes, how a child thinks about figures, and how a child thinks or measures dimension or look at the dimension of different spaces and figures. The first concept is the pre-number concept, in which there is a sub-concept called matching. Matching can be referred as one-to-one correspondence, that is matching one kind of objects with the other kind of objects. For example, if a child is asked to give the chocolate to all the toys, and if he places or she places chocolate in front of all the toys correctly, it can be said that he has or she has matched the object successfully. Therefore, matching forms the base of number system, though it invariably doesn't include the numbers. The second sub-concept which come under pre-number concept is sorting. Sorting can be referred as sparing and separating objects on the basis of their characteristics in different groups. For example, you can look at the tray which is there on your screen, in which different color of small toys are placed together. So it can be said that in early years, colors is first identified as prominent attribute on which the sorting is made by children. And afterward, they can have other attributes under consideration for sorting or sparing or separating different things in different groups. The third sub-concept under the pre-number concept is ordering. Ordering can be referred as seriation. Seriation on the basis of size, length, or height. We can order them, or we can put the things or the objects in order on the basis of their less and more size, on the basis of their short and long height, on the basis of their short and long length. The concept of ordering can be facilitated through the words such as order first, next, last, etc. These are the words which should be used to facilitate the concept of, or to make children gain the concept of, ordering. The fourth sub-concept under the pre-number concept is subitizing. Subitizing can be referred as identification of the pattern at a glance without counting or knowing the amount. Learner, as you are aware that pre-number concepts are developed in the age where the understanding or the knowledge of number is absent. Therefore, counting is not possible in this stage. And therefore, subitizing is referred to as identification of patterns at a glance without counting. As you can see or look at the visual, a child can easily tell that which of the square has more dots on it, or which of the sides of the dice has more dots on it. Subitizing also provides for an early perceptual basis for numbers, but it is without numbers. Now coming on the second mathematical concept category, which is number concept and operations on numbers. So under number concept, we are having counting. Counting refers to basic number concept and is acquired or well attained in the age of 3 to 5 years of age. When a child comes in a school, he or she is able to count 1 to 10. However, in rote, without according any meaning to 1 to 10 numbers, but he or she is able to count at least 1 to 10 objects. And he or she, as gains maturity in his life, comes around 5 years, the meaningful counting also starts. There are two aspects under counting. The first aspect is ordinal aspect, which refers to the order, that is, it answers the question, what is the position of a particular thing in the whole span of scheme. The second aspect of counting is cardinal aspect, which refers to the size, that is, it answers the question, how many objects are there. The cardinal aspects also involves conversation concept, and it develops after the age of 5 years because it is a bit complex aspect of counting. Coming on the second sub-concept of the number concept, that is use of numerals. Under use of numerals, counting refers to familiarity with numbers. That is, when we are using numbers, numbers are having some kind of meaning in it. And the meaningful use of numbers also requires the knowledge of structure of numerals used for different numbers, that is the place value and the decimal system. For example, please look at your screen. In 15, the 1 comes at 10th position and the 5 comes at 1 position. If the child is not able to understand the place value of the numbers, he or she won't be able to do or perform the different operations with the numerals. Coming on the third subconcept under the number concept, that is operation on numbers, there are four kind of operations of on numbers. The first operation or the first group of operation is addition and subtraction. Addition and reverse addition. Subtraction is also be termed as reverse addition. And the second group is multiplication and division, or the reverse multiplication. The division is also known as the reverse multiplication. When addition and subtractions are concerned, it is observed that a child of the age of 6 years and below can easily do simple addition and can easily do the reverse addition also. But the real understanding of the structure and the operation of addition and subtraction only comes around the age of 9 to 11 years, and that has also been taken under consideration when we are planning for the learning of the children in mathematics. Now coming on the second group of the operation on numbers, that is multiplication and division. As far as multiplication is concerned, multiplication can be learned when the child becomes able to do addition. That is, it can be introduced at the stage of or at the age of 6 to 7 years. However, in our school, multiplication is usually offered or introduced when a child is in 3rd class or roughly is of the age of 8 or 9 years, when he or she is able to understand the structure and the function of the addition clearly. The structural properties of multiplication and division can only be introduced when the child is at the age end of the concrete operational stage, that is at least after 10 to 11 years. Otherwise, the multiplication and the division would become a complex concept to be understood by the child, and he or she can have failures in doing multiplication and division clearly and correctly. Now coming on the third category of mathematical concept, that is measurement concept. Measurement concept depends upon two things, that is conservation and transitivity. Conservation refers to intactness of quantity in spite of changing its shapes or form. For example, if we take a water in a cylindrical glass and pour it in a long bottle, then it should be understood by a child to understand the measurement or to attain the measurement concept that the water has changed its form and shape, but it is intact in quantity. And the transitivity can be explained as the ability to draw a cross relation amongst related objects. For example, if A is established as equivalent or equal to B, and B is established as equal to C, then a child is able to understand that A is equal to C after cutting the B from in between, because B is in relation between A and C. It is making A equal to C. So, transitivity and conservation are the two things on which measurement concepts depends. Measurement concepts are also introduced after the age of 6 years. We can let the child use the simple scale and D to measure different lengths, the lines and the other scalar things. The exposure to linear dimensions should be given or used as the first step to teach or to make children learn the measurement concept, such as measuring a single line, then singular dimensions such as the square, the rectangle, the rhombus and the other things. But measurement of single line or the linear dimension should be introduced as the first step of learning measurement concept. The measurement concept reaches to final stage of measuring area and volume, etc., by calculating linear dimension at the age of 10 to 11 year, and after that the sophisticated measurement concepts begins to develop in the children and support children's cognitive development. The fourth type of concept, which comes under the category of mathematical concept, is the concept of spatial thinking. Spatial thinking invariably relates to discovering properties of spatial structure and shapes. For example, if there are different kind of shapes around the child should be able to categorize the different shapes into different categories on the basis of their different characteristics. Only after that he or she would be characterized as having spatial thinking, or he or she is characterized to think spatially. Spatial thinking in initial years is almost absent. For example, it can be said that for a child or a young child, the close and open figures are same. He is not able to identify that some figure is closed or some figure is open. He or she consider both the figures at the same figures. At the age of 3.5 years approximately, the child is able to distinguish between open and closed figures. That is, all closed figures are alike for him, the square, the rectangle or the circle. In spite of differences in the figures, for a child of 3.5 years, all these closed figures are same, because these falls under the category of closed figures for him or her. He or she is not able to understand the further categories of these closed figures. In an age of 7 to 8 years, the child is able to observe the minute distinctions between the closed and open figures. That is, he or she is able to distinguish if the two closed figures, for example, a square and a rhombus is given to a child, he or she is able to distinguish that both of these, in spite of being the closed figures, are different from each other. In the age of 10 years, the child is able to name the figures. For example, if you give a square, a circle or a rectangle to a child, he or she is able to name them correctly in the age of 10 and after that. The intricacy in the spatial thinking develops at the end of concrete operational stage, that is roughly at the age of 11 to 12 years, and mostly in formal operational stage. The most of spatial thinking grows when a child enters in a formal operational stage, that is 11 to 12 years and onwards. Now, to understand how the mathematics is learned during early childhood, there are some things special to be considered or to be discussed here. For example, maths need to be brought out of children's everyday life. That is, the math should be related to the real life of the child, and the examples in the mathematics should be drawn from the life of the children or day-to-day experiences of the children. And learning by doing should be promoted for more stable learning of mathematics and more clearer learning of mathematical concept. That is, the mathematics should be rooted in action. And the main aim of learning of mathematics at this stage should be in the development of mental images of the child than just being mechanistic. That is, if a child is made to learn certain concept, the imagery or the understanding of the concept should be clearer than to be a rote in nature. Otherwise, the mastery would be lacking, and the mastery should of the mathematical concept in the early childhood can only be attained through the tool of language. Therefore, the children should be encouraged to talk about the activities or the mathematical activities they are doing. And as a teacher, we should be open to accept the error the children are making, as the errors are the part of learning. What are the different mechanisms available to learn mathematics in early childhood? There are different kind of mechanisms and methods which are available for learning the mathematics at early childhood or promoting the learning of mathematics at early childhood. There are a few. We can make the children learn mathematics through the manipulation of objects. We are having different kind of children into our classes, and different learners are comfortable with different kind of objects and different uses of the objects or the resources available with us. The manipulation of the object and making children active would break the rote and promote the transfer of learning to real life situation. That is, whatever he or she learning in the class, he or she can apply or innovate with it after the class or away from the class. The second mechanism which is available with us to make children learn the mathematics during early childhood is placing the task in meaningful context. That is, contextualizing the mathematics. We should need to understand that children's life or relating mathematics to children's life is very, very important. Otherwise, they won't be able to relate with the learning, and mathematics will remain as an area of fear and phobia for them. Therefore, it is very, very important to place the mathematics in children's life and to make it meaningful for the children. Placing mathematics in real life situation also promotes the authentic learning. That is, whatever they are learning in the classes, they can test it and acquire it stably after the class. Placing the task in meaningful context for learning mathematics also provide real problems to work on. That is, by setting the subject free from the clutches of the textbook, it is becoming more and more practical and action oriented in nature. The third mechanism which is available or to promote the learning of mathematics during early childhood is multiple representation. We are having different kind of learner in our classrooms who can understand by different method, who can learn by different method, or who will prefer different method. Therefore, we should have concrete representations, visual representations, symbolic representation and demonstration, etc., to facilitate the good learning or the effective learning of mathematics in our classes. The fourth mechanism which is available with us is developing alternative strategy, that is, having alternative plans with us. It is essential to understand that if one plan works with some children, it is not a guarantee that that particular plan will work for other children also. So, looking at the individual differences of the children, we need to have alternative strategies to facilitate the learning of mathematics in early childhood. And therefore, we should also get out from the syndrome of one correct method. We should promote children to solve the mathematical problem in innovative manner and to come out with their own unique solution or the method to solve the problem. Then, problem solving should be facilitated as a mechanism to learn mathematics. It ensures the better engagement along with success, which leads to better motivation in the learner, and it also caters to individual differences, as the children are able to relate with the mathematics. And here are some golden rules for strengthening learning of mathematics and to inculcate love for mathematics. After going through the content of this lesson, there are four things which need to be kept in mind invariably for designing the learning experiences of the children in mathematics. The first thing is to contextualize the mathematical activities. The second is to pose the activities in challenging manner in front of the children so that they can enjoy and have fun in mathematics. Third thing is we should promote the creativity in performing the mathematical actions or mathematical tasks or activities. And the fourth and the final thing is we should promote practice in mathematics, and practice will sharpen the mathematical skills of the children. At the end, we can say that we have discussed about the whole notion of the concepts in general and mathematical concepts in particular. The mathematical concepts have broadly been categorized into four: pre-number concepts, numbers and operations, measurement concepts and special thinking. The development of each of the concepts follows the direction in cognitive development of the child. Early years of child lives are very important to ensure success in mathematics in the later life. Therefore, the learning of mathematics needs to be rooted in real life through actions to place its meaning and save it from just being a mechanical exercise. The learning of mathematics in early years and at elementary stage can be promoted through the manipulation of objects, contextualizing the task, multiple representation, problem solving, and developing strategies for learning of mathematics. In brief, contextualization, challenging, creativity, and practice can be considered as the core of effective learning mathematics. Now, there is time to take home task. I would like you to design an activity for your students of primary grades to make them learn multiplication and division as a mathematical concept. With this task, I would say you goodbye. Thanks. Thank you very much.